was wondering how long it was going to take Vea to convince you to follow me. But she thought I didn't notice when she glanced at my writ, didn't she? Where is my overly curious apprentice, by the way? I know Vea wants answers, but this is my job. There are rules, especially where the lords of the great houses are concerned. There might be a way to deal with this, though, provided you're willing to help. First, don't kill any veterans. That's a violation of my writ and could have serious consequences for both of us. Second, you sneak around and search for anything that pertains to Auron's exile while I figure out how to deal with the counselor. We need to be invisible. These things work best when no one but the target knows we're there. If you get spotted, you're on your own. I even cough on anyone without a writ, and the Morog Tong will have my head. It's unusual, but not unheard of. True, most writs taken out against the houses target low to mid-ranking officials. The Grand Master is cautious when it comes to accepting such a high-profile writ. Apparently, though, this target has been very bad. Counselor Dovera has been conspiring with House Drez to promote the slave trade and avoid scrutiny by Redwyn and Pact officials. She played a dangerous but profitable game, and her coffers were overflowing. Until someone noticed. I'm not privy to the laborious investigations that took place. In cases like these, though, the target usually becomes complacent and lets her guard down. She made a mess. Now I get to clean it up, for the good of Dunmer society. That's the question, isn't it? It nags at us the way the torchbug nags at the brave little scrib in those children's stories. Once we discover who Ulron's torchbug is, we'll have a clearer understanding of why they set him up and why he had to die. I'm not saying that. Accidents happen. They certainly made sure Ulron was in the wrong place at the wrong time, both in Balmora and again in the Ashlander camp. In addition to whatever you can find here, we should also talk to Captain Briven. Briven's name keeps coming up. At the very least, he was Ulron's best friend once. He might be able to shed some light on Ulron and what happened to cause his exile. And I really want to know what took place after Ulron left us that message. Bea's my apprentice, and I'll decide when she's ready to take on a mission. She's been through a lot, and her actions reflect on me and my status in the Morog Tong. She may not appreciate it right now, but I'm trying to keep the both of us on track. That's how it works. Her actions are my actions. Bea goes out and executes three writs. I share the credit and get praised for training my apprentice. On the other hand, if she kills someone without a writ, the Morog Tong takes both our heads. There have to be. My order came this close to being eliminated. It's only recently that we've started to make a comeback, and only in Dunmer territory. If we can't control the actions of our members, we'll be hunted down and destroyed for sure. Thank you. front door's guarded like a bank vault. Maybe there's another way in through one of the buildings by the docks. See what you can find pertaining to Ulron. I've got a dagger and a writ with Councillor Dolvar's name on them. So House Redoran issued an advisory against the Morog Tong? Fat lot of good that's going to do the Councillor.
Oh!
If we can find anything, maybe we can ask for an invitation to the upcoming council meeting. I'm sure they'd be happy to answer.